If you are an AWS professional and you are certified for almost 3 years, probably now you need to recertificate yourself. You need to renew your certificate. And how to do that? Looking for the material about how we can recertificate, one of the possibilities is playing this Cloud Quest, which is a training-based game, which you can just play online and you are going to renew your AWS certified cloud practitioner. But if like me, you also do not have exactly all the information you need for that, you don't have maybe enough time for joining this game, installing and so on, I will now give you important hints about how was my experience during this process. So, let's see that. One recurring question is, everyone can play this game to get certified? No, it's not exactly like that. Scrolling here in the certification webpage, you can see that it is an exam for certified individuals that currently is holding the AWS certified cloud practitioner to maintain their status active. It means your status should be yet active, and then during this period you can do that. And you can start with this Cloud Quest within the last 6 months of your certification. And here you can see that for my case, here we are currently in June from 2024, and then I have here almost 3 months left for this period, and then we can verify the certification using this code through this website. From your current certificate, you then click in the link, and then it opens this page here, and you can input here the validation code, and then you can verify your certified is yet active. So at this point, you are able to start the Cloud Quest game. So let's see how it works. So just looking for Cloud Quest game on Google, you find that very easily about how to find the main web page. So you just go on to try to log in, and you are going to be able to access the game. And one of the first questions we have is, okay, but how long takes to play this game? We need to play more than 1 day, 1 hour is enough, we need to play 5 hours. So how this game works? You access this game totally from your web browser. It takes some time to load, and you cannot use your smartphone. You need to do that from a desktop. And then once you are in the game, you need to complete 100% of the game to be able to obtain the certification. And then the game is composed of 12 challenges, and each challenge has more or less 8% of the game. So when you eat 3 challenges, you become 25%. So playing the 12 games, the challenges, you are going to obtain the 100%. So take in mind, you may take some challenges are easier, another takes more time. So in an average of 30 minutes per challenge, you could maybe take about 6 hours, four or six hours, depending on your proficiency with AWS console. So with that, now we have an idea of how long, how many hours do you need to complete the role game. But now you may ask, okay, but now I need to be online all these hours to play the game without interrupts, otherwise I have to do everything again. No, the game saves automatically your progress, so you can play 30 minutes one day, 1 hour another day, 30 minutes 3 days after. So you can enter in the game how many times you want to, and every action you do is automatically saved, so you don't need to save anything, you don't lose any progress you make. And you can do that along there is no time limit actually. So I have done that in about 3 weeks, playing just a few minutes every weekend with when I had time. So if every weekend you place some kind of goal, like this weekend I'm going to do 2 challenges, another weekend I'm going to do more 2 or 3 challenges. So step by step, you reach your goal. And then you may ask, okay, but these challenges, they are difficult. May I fail or have some problem to solve the challenges? Okay, they are not exactly difficult. You can give false answers and you are not going to be penalized by that. You can try again and again and again until you have success in the challenge. The game map, yes, is big, but you don't need to walk throughout the map. There, you can do that, of course, but there are a lot of shortcuts that you just click and your character moves automatically to the point where the challenge needs to be performed. Each challenge will have 4 steps. 1 introduction, first 1 introduction about the game environment, what's the goal of this challenge for the game context. The second step is some generic instructions, videos, and instructional material that support you about the content that you're going to be addressed. The third material, so they do that in the third point. For you pass, they give all the information step by step to be followed to perform what the challenge expects. And then here the fourth step is where you need to, most of them, open the AWS console in a virtualized way. They provide one lab where you can explore the skills and perform what they ask. And then you need to take codes from the instance, from the objects you create in the AWS console and paste here. So actually you play in a real environment. So that's a very nice thing from this game. You play everything in a real scenario, and just the things you do that there, you copy the codes from them, the identificators, paste here, and ask for validate. In case you met the requirements, you are going to paste, you're going to receive here a green message validating, and then this challenge is completed. Or if you do that false, here is going to be some feedback message, and then you can try again and again. Another question you may have is, okay, after I have done all the challenge, completed 100% of the game, how much time should I wait until receive the new certificate? It's automatic. After you have completed your last challenge, after you have reached here this 100% complete of completion of your actions, this screen is displayed, and then you receive this message. You have here a link that's going to deliver you to the online website for this certification, and you also receives one email containing your new certification data. And in the email you are going to receive, you are going to get the link for this certification, and then you can see that you have received this badge. You can verify your certification and about the dates you received that, that's valid, and so on. So here one important thing is that maybe in the beginning we had the expectation it will extend for more 3 years your old certificate, but it's not. Actually, your old certificate actually is going to expire. We have seen in the beginning of this video the expiry date had not changed. I have access that after completed this examination, but we receive a new Cloud Practitioner certificate after complete the game with the autocorrects. So with that, hope now you have more information if you have to run under your own CloudQuest game. Good luck.